Ciao Edoardo, and thank you for this important question. So I'll give you a couple of examples of what we mean. Number one, you wake up in the morning and you need heat to warm your milk. Number two, your mom and I drives you to school in our car. So things like heat and motion need an energy source in order to work. So that energy can come from different forms, and such as oil for heating, gas for our car, charcoal on our barbecue grill, and electricity to watch your preferred cartoons on TV. So in most cases, when we use one of these forms of energy, we also cause gas emissions. So these emissions, what we call greenhouse gas emission, can impact the environment. And when we say net zero, we refer to the balance between the amount of greenhouse gas we emit and the amount we can get rid of. So we look at the greenhouse gas emissions as a whole, and particularly what emission can be eliminated. So some can be removed by nature, like when trees take carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and produce oxygen from it. There are also changes in industrial processes that can help. And I hope that this answers your great question. The Paris Agreement aims to strengthen the global response to the threat of climate change by keeping a global temperature rise by century well below 2 degrees Celsius and to pursue effort to limit the temperature increase even further to 1.5 degrees Celsius by 2100. In this framework, oil and gas companies are investing and promoting structured policies and roadmap to manage the emissions, while governments around the world are paying increased attention to climate change and emissions and developing dedicated regulation. So they are committed to achieve net zero objectives that are specific for direct and indirect emission, precisely outlining goals for operating assets and value chain contribution. So the complexity of the emission entails multiple components. These include the different kinds of greenhouse gases, the variety of emission categories, data sources, quantification methodology, and consolidation. The main challenge is to shift as much as possible from emission estimation to more reliable data measurement that enables a deep focus on each specific context at granular level to take concrete actions. So in a world where there's an ever-increasing focus on sustainability that accelerates priority on health, safety, quality, and environment, Bureau Veritas is uniquely positioned to support you with emission data management. So through our BV Green line of services and solution, we assist you to quantify emission, identify hotspot, and progressively reduce emission to enable transparent communication about your progress toward net zero. And this relies on data collected at asset level from the field and organized into a digital process to ensure traceability at granular level and to help you execute your organization's sustainability strategy. So BV monitors and consolidates improvement results, providing you with the carbon progress label, which enables you to communicate on the progress and effectiveness of your emissions reduction projects.